Hello, I am going to teach you this day vector analysis. In this class, I will teach you the definition of vector analysis, triangle's law, unit and base vector, position vector, displacement vector, and the component of vector in 2D. Now, I will teach you what is vector. It is a physical quantity which has direction, magnitude, and obeys the certain rule of vector addition. Magnitude, direction, and certain rule of vector addition, such as triangle's law, parallelogram law of vector addition, or any other vector law of addition which is concerned with this chapter. Then we can say vector has magnitude, direction, and obeys certain rule of vector addition. This certain rule may be triangle's law. Then what is triangle's law? Parallelogram law, triangle's law, polygon's law, etc. Commutative law, etc. Now, what is triangle's law? When two vectors represent the two sides of a triangle, in cyclic order, then addition of both the vectors must be represented by third side of that triangle in opposite order. BC plus CA is equal to BA. BC plus CA is equal to BA. This can be represented experimentally. Consider this is the stone, a vector quantity A is acting horizontally parallel to vector A. Vector B act parallel to vector B represented on this stone in this direction. The resultant of both the vector quantity will act along BA, A plus B. A plus B is equal to R. If BA is equal to R, then A plus B is equal to R. The notation of vector is arrow, bar, cap, and bold letter. Here we note the vector, represent the vector in a triangle form or generally bar. The initial point, the vector which is starting from point A is called initial point, and the arrow point is called terminal point. Now we can teach you unit vector and base vector. What is unit vector? The vector whose magnitude is 1 numerically it is equal to the ratio of vector to its magnitude. It is always denoted under cap. It is always denoted under cap. Therefore, A cap is equal to A vector to its magnitude. The ratio of vector to its magnitude is called unit vector. If these vector are represented along x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, then these unit vectors are called base vectors. If these vectors are represented along x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, then it is called base vector. They are represented by I, J and K. I is represented along x-axis, J represented along y-axis and K represented along z-axis in positive direction. If we would like to determine these unit base vector along negative direction, then we have to take minus I along negative x-axis, minus J along negative y-axis and minus K along negative z-axis. These I, J, K are called base vector. The physical significance of these base, physical significance of these base vector is it can convert any scalar quantity into vector without changing its magnitude. For example, 4, if you have been given 4 and we write it 4i, that means 4 unit along x-axis, minus 4i, that means 4 unit along negative x-axis, 4k, 4 unit along positive z direction. So we can say this base vector can convert any physical quantity, any scalar quantity into vector quantity without changing its magnitude. Now note it. You can take a screenshot also. Now I will further go to the another topic, position vector. This one is most important topic in vector analysis. Position vector is the most important topic. Position vector is the most important topic in vector analysis. What is position vector? This is also called radius vector. Position vector is also called radius vector. What is position vector? Orientation of a point with respect to origin is called position vector. In two dimensions, x axis and y axis, P be the point having coordinate xy, O is the origin. The line joining O to P is called position vector. O to P, this point is called position vector. This is also called radius vector. The point P have coordinate xy. We draw perpendicular PM. Now we draw perpendicular PM. Then OM is equal to X, and OM vector is equal to XI, because any scalar quantity can be converted into vector quantity by using base vector. Along X axis the base vector is I, so OM vector is equal to XI. Now PM is equal to Y. According to coordinate system, this is Y, this is X. Then PM vector is equal to YJ minus YJ. Y minus YJ, because the direction of P to M is along negative Y axis. So it is taken minus YJ. If we take MP, then it will be equal to YJ. MP, then it is equal to YJ, and PM is equal to XJ. Now from triangle's rule, from triangle's law, OM plus MP is equal to OP. Here OM is equal to XI. Here OM is equal to XI. MP is equal to YJ. And OP is equal to R. So if P point, now we take another example. If P point is have coordinate minus 2, minus 3, then the position vector is equal to, in first coordinate, we we add base vector I and the sign plus, then we take plus sign, and then other ordinates we take j. Therefore, the position vector of point P having coordinate minus 2 and 3 is equal to minus 2i plus 3j. From Pythagoras, OP ka whole square is equal to PM square plus OM square. We know that OP is equal to R square, PM is equal to Y square, and OM is equal to X square. Therefore, R is equal to root over X square plus Y square. This is the magnitude of this position vector. Now, in this example, the magnitude can be written as R magnitude is equal to minus 2 ka whole square. The coefficient of I should be taken minus 2 ka whole square, and coefficient of j should be taken plus 3 ka whole square, whole root over. Minus 2 is equal to 4, plus 3 ka whole square is equal to 9, root 13. Hence we can say, if P is the point having coordinate minus 2 comma 3, the position vector will be minus 2i plus 3j. We can write it directly, and we can also write directly the magnitude, the coefficient of I ka whole square and plus coefficient of j ka whole square. We get the magnitude of that position vector. We can also determine the direction of that position vector. Let angle POM is equal to theta. Then tan theta is equal to PM by OM. PM by OM perpendicular by base. Theta is equal to tan inverse PM. The value of PM is equal to Y and OM is equal to X magnitude if it is in first quadrant. Okay. Take a screenshot or note this chapter. Note this topic. Now we can explain it with this example, the direction. And different in different coordinate, we take different direction. Again, we take another point P. For example, we take another point P having coordinate minus 4, comma minus 6. Then we can directly write its position vector minus 4i plus 6j, minus 6j, because the coordinate, the coefficient of 6 is minus and coefficient of 4 is also minus 1. Now we can write the magnitude. The magnitude of R is equal to minus 4 ka whole square plus minus 6 ka whole square ka root over 16 plus 36 root 52. This is the magnitude of the position vector of point P. Now direction. This position vector will represent the coordinate third. How can you identify the coordinate system? Now write this way. This is the plane thing representing x-axis real axis and imaginary y-axis. This is the real axis. If both are positive, both the coordinate are positive, then the point is represented in first quadrant. If first one, x coordinate is negative and y coordinate is positive, then it will represent in second quadrant. If both are negative, then it will be represented in third quadrant. And if x is positive and y is negative, then position vector will be represented in fourth quadrant. Okay. For first quadrant, the direction will be tan theta is equal to tan inverse y by x mod. For second quadrant, theta is equal to pi minus tan inverse y by x mod. Or for third quadrant, theta is equal to pi plus tan inverse y by x mod. And for the fourth quadrant, theta is equal to 2 pi minus tan inverse y by x mod. These are the direction of position vector represented along first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant respectively. Here this position vector will lie in third quadrant because the coefficient of I is also negative and J is also negative. I have also negative. Now, the direction of this position vector will lie in third quadrant because the coefficient of I is negative and J is also negative. And the negative negative represent the third quadrant. So, the direction of this position vector will be theta is equal to pi plus tan inverse 6 by 4 mod 3 by 2. That is pi plus tan inverse 3 by 2 mod. This is the direction. Now we can give another example. Note it. Now we will give another example. A person moves 4 meters north, 6 meters east, 3 meters south, 8 meters west. Find the resultant. Of these vector quantities, these displacements. Four meter north, 6 meter east, 3 meter south, 8 meter west. Find the resultant of these displacements. The position vector can be used on all type of vector quantity, whether the velocity, the vector quantity is velocity, acceleration, force, anywhere you can use this one. This is most important term in the physics. If you understand this one, I think at least 4 and 5 chapter of physics 11 and 12 you can understand very well. Here, to find out the resultant of these displacement, first of all you have to draw the coordinate system, x and y axis, and we write north and east. According to map, first person moves 4 meter north, that means it will represent 4 meter along, 4 meter north, that means it will represent 4 meter north along positive y axis. 6 meter east, that means it will represent along positive x axis. 3 meter south, that means it will represent negative y axis, 3 meter. Give arrow also in this direction. And 8 meter west, that means it will represent negative x axis, 8 meter. Now we can write x here in x axis. In this diagram it is obvious that 6 meter is along positive x axis and 8 meter is along negative x axis. Negative, that means you should have taken negative, and positive, that means you should have to taken, you should have to take positive. That means 6 is positive and 8 is negative. And the base vector along x-axis is taken I. So we can write minus 2i. Now y, 4 is along positive y-axis, that means it is taken positive. And 3 is along negative y-axis, that means it will take a negative. And the base vector is represented along, this y is represented by base vector along j, because it represents the y-axis. Now this is equal to j. So, the position vector will be minus 2i with this proper sign and plus j with that proper sign. Now, we can determine the magnitude. Minus 2 ka whole square plus 1 ka whole square ka root over 4 root 5. In which quadrant this, the direction of this position will be? In second quadrant, because I is negative and j is positive. So, theta is equal to, can see the previous paper, theta is equal to pi minus tan inverse 1 by 2 mod. This is the direction of that resultant position vector, the resultant of this displacement. This is the direction, this is magnitude, and this is the position, this is the resultant. Now we can write displacement vector. What is displacement vector? Note this one. Or you take a screenshot also. What is displacement vector? Difference between the difference between the position vector of terminal point and initial point, not initial and terminal, terminal point and initial point. So this is the terminal point and this is initial point. If this one has coordinate x1, y1 and this one has coordinate x2, y2, then position vector of point A, is equal to x1i plus y1j. पहले भी समझाए थे इसको आपको कि हमेशा पहले वाले में i लेंगे, दूसरे वाले में j लेंगे. Now the position vector of point B, this is equal to x2i and y2j. Now displacement vector will be equal to the position vector of terminal point minus position vector of initial point. Here position terminal point is point B, that position vector is x2i plus y2j minus position vector of point A, x1i plus y1j. x2 minus x1i plus y2 minus y1j. You can write the magnitude x2 minus x1 ka whole square, coefficient of I and coefficient of j, y2 minus y1 whole square root over. If both are represent, both the coordinate are plus, so if the displacement vector will be represented in first quadrant. So theta is equal to tan inverse y2 minus y1 x2 minus x1 mod. This is the direction of displacement vector, this is the magnitude of displacement vector, and this one is the displacement vector of between two points. Now note this one or take a screenshot. Now we going to teach you component of vector in 2D. This is also very important topic. Students must care on that topic. Should have to be careful. I have to learn this one. This is most important because all the vector quantity can be resolved according to this method. And what is component? Component of a vector. Resolution of a vector into two and more than two vector is called resolution, and the resolved vectors are component. If they are mutually perpendicular to each other, then it is called rectangular resolution. For example, again we take coordinate system in two dimension. This is y axis, this one x axis. P be the point having coordinate xy, position vector r, because it is at a distance of r from the origin. Now we draw perpendicular PM on x axis. This one is y and this is one is x. Let angle POM is equal to theta. Then theta, then in triangle POM, sin theta is equal to P by H, PM by OP. The PM is Y and OP is R. Therefore, Y is equal to R sin theta. This is called Y component. Cos theta is equal to OM by OP. Base by hypotenuse. OP. OM is equal to X and OP is equal to R. Therefore, X is equal to R cos theta. This is called X component. Note this one, or you can take a screenshot. To explain this component, we take an example. A person moves 4 meter. Person moves 4 meter north, 4 root 2 meter southeast 10 meter making 37 degree west of south. Find the resultant of this displacement. Find the resultant. We can again solve this one by using position vector. Now we draw, first of all, we draw coordinate system. X is taken along x axis, and this one is y axis. This is real axis. Real axis is represented by x, and imaginary axis is represented by y. Here we draw the mapping system. Above one is north, this one is east. North, 4 meter north, that means it will represent y axis 4 meter. 4 root 2 meters southeast, that means this is east and this one is south. Angle is not given, southeast is given, that means it will make angle 45 degree from either side. 4 root 2 meter southeast. 10 meter making 37 degree west of south. West of south means south se west ki or. President samajhna jaruri hai isko. South say west, you should have taken south to west. The angle should be taken from south to towards west. This is west, this is south. So angle should be taken from south towards west, 37 degree, 10 meter. So this angle should be south of west. If it is written as west of south of west, that means this angle should be will be taken 37 degree. Here, west of south, that means 37 degree, will be, this angle will be 37 degree, okay? You have to know sine 37 is equal to 3 by 5, cos 37 is equal to 4 by 5, and tan 37 is equal to 3 by 4. Similarly, we can find out the value of 53 degree also. Now, this is along y-axis, but this one, and this two vector quantity neither in y-axis or nor in x-axis. They are in quadrant, third quadrant as well as in fourth quadrant as well as in third quadrant. So we have to take the component of these vector quantity. The vector, the angle side, the vector can be resolved along the angle, should be taken cosine, and 4 root 2 cos 45 degree. And other, the just perpendicular of that component should be taken 4 root 2 sine 45. Now 10, the vector 10 can be resolved, the angle in this way. So this is 10 cos 37, and just perpendicular of this will be sine 37. Now x axis is equal to 4 root 2 cos 45. This is along positive axis, so it is taken positive. And this one is along negative axis, so it is taken negative. And value should be put 4 root 2 sine 45 1 by root 2 minus 10 cos sine 37, sine 37 3 by 5, 5 to the 10, root 2 root 2, 4 minus 6, that is equal to minus 2i. Because base vector, I represent the base vector along x axis. Now y is equal to 4 in positive axis, so it is taken positive. 4 root 2 sine 45 is along negative y axis, so it is taken negative. And as well as 10 cos 37 is also along negative y axis, so again taken negative cos 37. Now we put the value of 45 and 37. 4 minus 4 root 2 sine 45 is equal to 1 by root 2 minus 10 cos 37 is equal to cos 37 4 by 5. 5 to the 10, 4 minus 4 minus 8, 4 4 cancel, minus 8j. So the resultant will be r is equal to, first x component is minus 2i, y component is minus 8j. This is the resultant of these vector quantities. The magnitude of this resultant will be minus 2 ka whole square, minus 8 ka whole square ka root over 4 plus 64 root 68. This position vector or this resultant represented in 4 third quadrant because I is also negative and J, the coefficient of J is also negative. So minus minus is represented in third quadrant. So the direction will be 2 pi minus pi plus tan inverse 8 by 2. Theta is equal to pi plus tan inverse 4. This is the direction. This one is magnitude. This is the resultant. These are the component. This is y component. This is x component. Okay, guys, in next class.